Detective Kinnix, this is a preliminary report. Detective Paul is up there, sir.
I'm sorry, there's not much we can do about that.
Victim is Anton Cross. Lived in Lakeshore Heights. Single gunshot wound to the upper torso. Large caliber round.
What do you got?
Looks like three shots fired. One through the skylight, one through that guy's cello, and one in the Mr. Lucky here, which fragmented on the wall. The transit police said he was running. They stopped him on the platform. He was agitated, saying, they're gonna kill me.
Three shots and no one saw a shooter?
Correct. And we only recovered one bullet.
One bullet.
It is possible that a single bullet was responsible for all three impacts. If fired from the perfect angle and traveling along a consistent trajectory, I believe a bullet could have cut through the skylight, continued through the cello, bounced against the wall, ricocheted to the floor, and penetrated the victim's chest cavity.
Mm-hmm.
Let me get this straight. You're suggesting that a single bullet came through the skylight, ricocheted and bounced its way through the subway, and then just miraculously hit a man square in the chest who was, according to witnesses, running, screaming, they're gonna kill me.
While the likelihood seems improbable, there is a 0.004% chance that a shooter, firing with this morning's 5 miles per hour northwesterly winds, would release a bullet that would only increase speed until hitting the skylight, where the trajectory would change nominally and the bullet would increase velocity due to air conditioning within the station. A temporary deformation coupled with inertia and the molecular structure of the wall, the cello, and the floor would inevitably allow for a fatal impact.
Mm-hmm. Makes sense to me.
What do you think?
Obviously, this is just a first look, but it appears that there's only residue from the skylight and residue from the cello, yet there's no residue from the floor, making the likelihood that it bounced or ricocheted unlikely.
Detective Kinnix, I appreciate you seeking multiple scenarios as to how this homicide occurred, and I understand your partner is trying to assist you. However, I must remind you that your partner is a DRN, a discontinued...
Please, do continue.
If you look here, there seems to be some sort of circuitry that's embedded in the slug, and we can't be sure until we get a full analysis. But these markings don't look like scratches from a bullet hitting a wall.
Again, Detective Kinnix, your DRN is inferior.
It's not something you see every day. On top of that, I genuinely believe that one bullet did do all of this damage, just not a ricochet, as suggested by Detective Paul's MX.
You are continuing to listen to a retired, old system, believing the rambling and illogical theories of your appropriately canceled partner. If you would like, I can put in a request for you to be partnered with an MX4.
Are you out of your mind? You do not draw your weapon, let alone fire it in a public place, unless you're...